This was taken right after the funeral.
It's been 38 years, and it's still hard for Audrey Brown to look at the pictures.
Yeah, I don't get them out. I haven't had them out for quite a while.
Pictures of her murdered family, the Kellys, all gunned down in their Sutherland home in 1975.
This is my dad. This is my mom. This is my brother. This is Florence. This is Deanna, and this is Danny.
Six caskets.
The killer, the 29-year-old next-door neighbor, Erwin Charles Simants.
I think he's just an evil man.
Evil because of how and why he killed her family, starting with 10-year-old Florence.
When he raped little Florence, that she cried, and so he killed her. Shot my mom in the eye and shot my dad on the right side of his neck.
By the time Simon stopped shooting, six people were dead. He was caught, confessed, and convicted, then sent to death row. But that verdict was overturned after it was discovered the sheriff played cards with some of the sequestered jury members. Then, at a second trial in Lincoln, a psychiatrist testified they thought Simons, who'd been drinking, was schizophrenic. He was found not guilty by reason of insanity and has lived at the regional center ever since.
I never have really felt that he was insane because he planned so many things. To go in the house when there was only one little girl there, turn out the lights, kill them one by one.
Now every year, Simons has a hearing to see if his psychological status has changed. And every year, Audrey and her husband, Mel, drive to Lincoln to be there. And for more than 20 years, this man has defended Simons.
At this point, he's essentially just being warehoused.
Bob Lindemeyer is the Lincoln County Public Defender. His assessment, the 67-year-old Simons is sane.
He were just sitting in a room and someone didn't know who he was. They just think he was an old grandfatherly looking fellow.
The question is, does District Judge Donald Rollins, the man who will decide Simon's fate, agree? And even if he doesn't, would he have to set Simons free?
I think the law is clear that if a person's no longer mentally ill, they can't be held.
You see, Nebraska law is limited in this case. To keep someone committed, that person has to be both mentally ill and dangerous.
Clearly, you can make the argument anybody that's killed six people remains dangerous. The question is whether he remains mentally ill.
And Lindemeyer says he isn't, according to four mental health professionals who recently examined Simons. That said, when I asked Lindemeyer if he would be okay with Simons living in his neighborhood,
good question.
It made him stop and think.
That's hard. I mean, I don't know. I'd be difficult, I think, on a number of reasons, but I don't know that I can answer that honestly.
The Kelly house used to stand right behind me, but it's long since been torn down. We've been told that's because no one wanted to live in a house with such a dark history. But while the house is gone, the memories aren't.
There's one here and one here, and then this was all gone, and he shot him underneath here.
June Lindstrom still lives in Sutherland. She was on the rescue squad that night and was one of the first into the house.
The people that are saying that he's cured was not there and did not see what he'd done.
She saw it and wanted to make sure it was never forgotten. So after getting home from the hospital that night, she sat in this kitchen and made this audio recording. For the first time, it's being played publicly.
I looked around and my first thought was, my God, what happened? Because at the first glance, I seen four bodies. The little girl, she was crumpled like a little rag doll. I still get this impression in my mind. She was in this corner like she was trying to hide. In the process of moving Danny from his father so I could get to him, the body was still warm to touch and limp.
Emotions still raw, fueled by the crime and its extreme depravity. There are reports Simons tried to have sex with two of the victims after they were dead. When June saw Marie dead in the corner, Marie's skirt was pushed up around her waist. June knew she couldn't tamper with the scene, but still, she wanted to cover her friend.
I wanted to protect her dignity from everybody that was coming in because she was such a proud lady, and I just wanted to protect her.
What about raping my mother after she was dead? How gross is that?
Even 38 years after burying six of her family members here, Audrey Brown is worried. Worried Simants might come looking for her. Worried people will forget what he did. Worried the state will let a confessed mass murderer walk.
Whether he's insane or not, he still murdered six people. And he ought to have to pay for murdering the six people.